Today, we're here at the magnificent Hatchlands House, which has an amazing collection of historic pianos, and we are going to record Napoleon's piano.
This is one of our items. This is Napoleon's piano. We were approached by the film company. Could they come and record some of the soundtrack on it? And we're delighted.
When they said we're going to record on Napoleon's piano, I mean, I had no idea what that even meant, really. I mean, in what sense it was his piano. People, there's so many things out there. People say this was Napoleon's piano, and of course it isn't. This actually is. I think it's just that thing for a film, a small thing like that can make, I mean, someone who watches the film is not necessarily going to listen to that and go, I recognise that piano, that's Napoleon's. But I think for us, it gives it a kind of significance and maybe a sort of resonance that you just can't put your finger on. But it's very exciting.
The whole point of the Museum of Music History is to put things in context and to help musicians discover the truth, which is all we do as musicians. We want to find the truth behind the score. And if we've got original instruments like this, not just their sound, as you'll hear on the soundtrack, but their touch, the feel, music is sensory as much as it's anything, as much as movement. You see the pianist playing away, but it's what they're feeling. And if we can give that back to modern performers and modern composers, the sound and the sensory world of these instruments, that's why we exist as a museum. It's for musical purpose, not just historical purpose, but it's a genuine help to musicians of today.
We now know that it's all Napoleon's piano, and maybe through this film other people might know too. And if that contributes to their feeling and understanding of a character and their connection with it, then that's a job well done. That's a really, really nice extra layer for the film.